Hello. I like to make today cherry pie cupcakes, which is we make them cherry, apple pie, blueberry pie, and even we can make orange pie. So it's very easy. And what we can do is we're using a standard muffin tray, which is we line with the foil cupcake bases, as you can see. So once we've done all of that, next is choose which one you like. This recipe goes very well. Would that be vanilla cupcakes, which is we can use actually cake mix, doesn't really matter, or chocolate cake mix? It goes very well as well. So basically, once they're baked, as you can see, they come out. Do not fill up too much, otherwise they rise too much. So you want to have nice and neat appearance, basically. This is how they come out. This is particular vanilla ones. So once it's all done, they now baked and cooled, so they're ready for decoration. So to decorate, we make a cookie dough icing. We have 170 gram of unsalted butter, which is softened, and we have 85 gram of brown sugar. So what we do is we beat with our electric mixer until it's nice and smooth. Once butter and brown sugar is smooth, we add 1¾ cup of powdered sugar or icing sugar. It doesn't matter, it's something. It depends which country you live. So once you incorporate, as you can see, it's quite thickish, sort of we get it, but that's okay. What we do is we add 1/4 teaspoon of salt, and we have 1/2 cup of plain flour. But with plain flour, what we do, we add only half. Once we incorporated half, we add the remaining half and incorporate it together. And last ingredients are left 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence and some milk. With milk, we need to add enough to make sure it's become nice, smooth, kind of pipeable consistency. So let's incorporate our flour into two addition. Once you add flour in two additions, as you can see, basically your cookie dough icing would be quite stiff. So what we do is, as I said before, we need to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence and enough milk to make it more spreadable. I add 4 tablespoons, and as you can see, it's quite spreadable, nice. So you don't want it too runny, you don't want it too thick, to sort of, it's otherwise it's hard to pipe it. See, this is nice spreadable consistency. So I added 4 tablespoons of milk, but it just depends how soft your butter was, because it just depends what sort of room temperature it was. Now for decorating our pies, we can use different color M&Ms. As you can see, we've done it apple pie, we use green M&Ms, and this is blueberry pie, we use blue M&Ms, and orange pie, use orange one. So for the cherry pie, we use, of course, red color M&Ms, and what we do is, for that, we spread our cookie dough icing all over our prepared cupcake. Just enough to sort of cover, don't need hugely much. And what we do is simply we arrange our M&Ms on top. I think good idea also to place, make sure actual letter M underneath to make sure it's more clear image as well. So we cover whole entire surface of the basically our cupcake. So we finish up with the covering, and what we do is with the I think I place this one the other side, so we just exchange it. And basically what we do with the our cookie do icing, we will place into piping bags, which is you can fit with any basically, as you can see here, it's all nicely done, attached beautifully. So, to make this little pie lines, we just using tip number 3. We place it cookie dough icing into piping bag, fitted with a tip number 3. So what we do is now we simply pipe it as it was a pie. It takes about 4 lines. As you can see, we completed 4. And so what we do is we just twist it on other side and continue this way. Also, of course, you can make them into mini little pies as well. This little line does not want to go into right direction, so we need it. Help it. Oops, now we connected. Now, next step, once our basically topping is done, you can use, this is tip 104. As you can see, it's like that kind of long sort of leafy tip. What we will do, you will get something like that. Sort of by piping wavy motion, or simply use any tip of your choice really. This one, for example, just a simple fluted tip. And what we do is we just using on outside of our cherry pie. We keep going like this until we complete it whole way around to make it nice and even. And as you can see, it's very, very entertaining type of cupcakes. And it's, of course, it's great for lovers of various pies. Here we are. We just move a little bit that around. And here we are, our little pies. You can make, of course, as I said before, you can make them into mini cupcakes or standard and decorate them with a cookie dough icing. Everything will be in the description box. And thank you very much for your time with me today. I hope you do like this simple creation of a pie cupcakes. Thank you. Until next time, goodbye.